Dear friends and subscribers, welcome back. Well, I actually uploaded a YouTube broadcast and probably wouldn't know, probably there was some error on my part here, unfortunately. But I'm out here to once again talk on this cricket happening show. So let me just, probably this is going to be a short show because I did all the talking and then it conked off, and then I saw that the video was not being processed, there's some problem. Anyway, it's probably not YouTube's problem, it is my problem. So I seem to have reset everything and I'm restarting again. Well, so once again, welcome to the Cricket Happening Show, dear friends and subscribers. Well, in this Cricket Happening Show, what you're going to look at is the, as you know, Zimbabwe are touring Bangladesh and they're going to play three test matches and some one-day matches. So Bangladesh have actually picked up the team for the first test match, and let's have a look at this Bangladesh test squad that has been selected. Now, Mushfiqur Rahim, well, he's retained the captaincy, so he will be captaining the side. Tamim Iqbal is the vice captain of the team. Now, the good thing to happen for Bangladesh, according to me, is the return of Shakib al Hassan after he was banned for some disciplinary reason. Then the ban was relaxed with the Bangladesh Cricket Board, and I'm very, very happy to see that Shakib al Hassan would be in full colors here against Zimbabwe, and that was very, very important that Shakib al Hassan had to get some real match practice here, because before the World Cup, he's such an important person for Bangladesh in the World Cup 2015, and I'm very, very happy to see that Shakib al Hassan is back in the mix of things for Bangladesh. And he is one person who could be a big difference because what he does is he contributes in all the departments of the game, which is great. So Shakib al Hassan is back, and I'm sure the Bangladesh supporters would be absolutely delighted to have their hero, Shakib al Hassan, the Dada, one could call him. Shakib al Hassan is back. Now, the Shamsur Rahman, whatever the limited opportunities he has got, I thought he has done well, so he retains his place. Mominul Haque has always been a very, very talented bloke who really, really loves to play strokes. He finds, but there's no place for Anamul Haque, because he was a bit of a, there was a bit of struggle for Anamul Haque. So Anamul Haque is out of the team, but Nasir Hossain, the experienced player, is also out of the team. Now, as you know, Nasir Hossain was not really, really contributing. He was probably making 20, 30 odd runs and not contributing. And the Bangladesh Cricket Board has come down very heavily on him by dropping him from this particular test match. And I'm sure he would be going back to the drawing board and getting things right and coming back really, really a charged Nasir Hossain. But let me tell you, Nasir Hossain will definitely come back, because he's a very, very talented player, and he's also one who could one day become a Shakib al Hassan of Bangladesh, because he definitely has the talent. He bats well, he bowls well, he's a brilliant fielder, and I'm sure Nasir Hossain will be back into the Bangladesh test squad in the future. I wish him good luck. Let's have the ball. Look at the bowling. Rubel Hossain, I always have felt that he has not really, really lived up to his name. It's very high time that against Zimbabwe, Rubel Hossain really, really pulls up his socks. Shogata Hum is the all-rounder who is there in the mix. Mahmudullah is the other all-rounder. And looking at the pace bowling, one thing that I would like to say here is that this pace bowling, the Bangladesh pace bowling has been strengthened with the return of Shahdat Hossain. Now, Shahdat Hossain, as you would remember, always used to bowl with a grand. He's a very tall guy. He has the perfect build as far as the pace bowler is concerned. He has played 35 tests, but due to injury, he has been out of the Bangladesh side. But I'm very happy to see that Shahdat Hossain has been selected. And Shahdat Hossain, as you know, the one thing that I would say by bringing Shahdat Hossain, what Bangladesh have done is added some firepower onto the pace department, because he's a very, very fiery bowler. And he can really, really make the ball talk at times. And he would be supported by Shafiul Islam, the end bowler, who is also a very good bowler. And then they have Al-Hamin Hussain, who has always been impressive in whatever the opportunity has gone. He's an upcoming bowler for Bangladesh, Al-Hamin Hussain, no doubt about it. And then Tajul Islam, of what we little saw, we saw that he made his debut against India. and the One Day Internationals, and Tajul Islam has also been selected. So, and Marshall Ayub, who has been scoring lots of runs in the Bangladesh domestic tourneys, also gets. But the one player that we would be talking about, and is a new player who is entering the Bangladesh cricket team, is a player by the name Jubair Hossain. Now, Jubair Hossain, let me tell you, dear fans and subscribers, he is a specialist leg spinner for Bangladesh. And Bangladesh, as you know, have not had any specialist leg spinners. They definitely had leg spinners. They had definitely had bowlers who were actually bowling leg spin. And readily, there are three names which come to mind. One of Mohammad Ashraful, who is no longer there in Bangladesh cricket now, was banned. And then Alok Kapali is an all-rounder, used to bowl a bit of leg spin. Shakib al Hassan also bowled leg spin. Now, other than that, but these were all like, you know, part-time leg spin bowlers. So this is the first time that Jubair Hossain, they have a specialist leg spinner in the form of Jubair Hossain. Now, the reason that he has really got the nod here, and I'm also told that Jubair Hossain also picked up a hat-trick against Zimbabwe, so in an under-19 match. So, and they feel that he's a very, very, very fine test prospect, probably a future prospect for Bangladesh. You know, because of Sohag Ghazi being tested for suspect bowling, this is the place, this is the time where Jubair Hossain has capitalized, in the sense the selectors have really decided to give him an opportunity and see. And why not? Jubair Hossain, as you know, in leg spin is something has been a rarity for Bangladesh, and probably will that be turning their fortunes in the test matches? One has to wait and see. Pretty early to say anything. Because international cricket is a different ball game altogether, and Jubair Hossain, well, he would be probably hoping that he could pick up this would be his best opportunity to take advantage of and pick up some wickets against Zimbabwe and show that he's some material. And so Jubair Hossain is the new right-arm leg-spinning bowler who has been included in the Bangladesh cricket team. Sohag Ghazi, as you know, is out, and other than that, as I said, Anamul Haque does not find a place. There's no place for Nasir Hussain. This is the format. This is the test squad that has been selected for the first test between Bangladesh and Zimbabwe, which is going to be played at the capital of Bangladesh, Dhaka, on 25th of October. Well, we do have some cricket coming in. There are, as you know, the West Indies actually left the Indian shores pretty early because of the dispute between the West Indies Cricket Players Association and the WICB, the West Indies Cricket Board, unfortunately, and Sri Lanka are the ones who are going to be fill that spot when they come and tour India in November. Probably after a gap of 5 years, Sri Lanka will be coming to India, and they'll be playing 5 one-day internationals. That is one thing. And also, Sri Lanka have and India would be going next year to Sri Lanka to play test matches. So that is something. That is good. That has turned out to be. Other than that, cricket. Well, we know that the Australia-Pakistan Test series is about to start. That is something that one is keenly looking forward to, just coming up. South Africa are already in New Zealand. I reckon South Africa are already in New Zealand. So they are going to play a series of test matches and one-day internationals against New Zealand. So that tour has been keenly watched. So there's a lot of cricket coming in, dear fans, subscribers. We are not short of cricket at all. Cricket is coming all the way through. Okay, now let's have a look at this. While talking about South Africa, the first one-day international is going to be started at Mount Maunganui. Now, this is going to be a new venue as far as New Zealand is concerned, because this is the first time Maunganui is hosting the one-day international. So this will be an international venue now, which will be making its international debut as a new ground, where New Zealand and South Africa will be starting their one-day series, this will be on 21st of October. So we are talking on 21st of October. It is on a Tuesday. Now, the squad has been selected for the first ODI. And the squad from New Zealand, well, it includes Brendan McCullum, captain, Corey Anderson, Trent Bolt, Dean Brownlee has won a comeback. I mean, in the sense, he has come back into the team because he probably scored a lot of runs in the sense he scored a lot of runs, and that's the reason he has got an opportunity here. And the reason this Brownlee have come is because of the injuries to Kane Williamson, who is not playing, which is very sad because Kane Williamson has been doing a pretty good job. Tom Latham has come into the side too at the age of 22. And then they have Martin Guptill, Matt Henry, a very, very fine pace prospect for New Zealand, Tom Latham, Mitchell McClanahan, Nathan McCullum, Kyle Mills, James Neesham, an upcoming all-rounder for New Zealand, Luke Ranchi, who has been delivering the goods as a wicketkeeper batsman for New Zealand, Tim Southee, and they have Daniel Vettori. So Daniel Vettori, now that is something which is very important to see, that Daniel Vettori, who played against Scotland in that very, very close game that New Zealand had against Scotland, he's back in the mix of things, and very happy to see that Daniel Vettori, one would hope that Daniel Vettori would be playing his last World Cup in 2015, and I'm sure we might have Daniel Vettori. I have a strong feeling that Daniel Vettori, after playing the World Cup in his own homeland, that is in New Zealand, in 2015, will probably, that would be his last World Cup because of his injuries and all those things. And I have a strong feeling that Daniel Vettori might hang up his boots after the World Cup 2015. But I would definitely, definitely love to see this bloke, Daniel Vettori, an experienced player, a very good contributor to international cricket, whether it be with the bat or the ball or the field. He's such a good, versatile cricketer, and he's actually back. So it is good to see that Daniel Vettori will be bowling against the South Africans. And one would really, really love to watch Daniel Vettori weave his arm round and bowl to the South Africans. Well, dear fans and subscribers, I think I am almost coming to an end of this cricket happening show. It's probably a 10-minute cricket show today. As I said, I loaded one and it didn't go through, and then I had to sit down and load my second YouTube broadcast, dear friends and subscribers. Well, so that's the reason I had to shorten my YouTube broadcast. Hope you all understand. Thanks for your continuous company to the Cricket Happening Show, dear fans and, subscribers. And I'll be seeing you tomorrow, and we'll see what is the probably tomorrow being the 20th of the month. We are looking at 20th of the month on Monday. So probably it could be a preview of the matches which is coming up, and that should be a South Africa New Zealand ODI which is coming up at Mount Managuni, which is the new international venue in New Zealand, which will be hosting its very first international match. Well, dear fans, subscribers, on this note, I think it's time for me to take leave on the Cricket Happening Show this on a Sunday. Thanks for your continued cooperation to the Cricket Happening Show, dear fans, subscribers. Your host, Ram, will see you tomorrow on your next Cricket Happening Show. Until then, it's goodbye on this on a Sunday. Thank you.